A recent brain experiment suggests that our brains may not be classical, but operate in a quantum mechanical way. If brain processes depend on quantum mechanics, it may explain why our brains are so powerful. This study suggests that some of our brain activity, even consciousness, may operate at the quantum level. Although supercomputers can beat us at tasks like chess, our brains can process and interpret information that computers cannot compete with, such as explaining events, situations, using imagination, creativity, and problem-solving skills. Our brain is an astonishingly powerful computer that uses not only neurons but also the connections between them to process and interpret information. How our brain consciousness arises is one of the most complex questions. Some scientists in the past have suggested that quantum processes, including entanglement, may help explain the vast capabilities of the brain and its consciousness. Recently, scientists at Trinity College Dublin have suggested that entanglement may be at play in our brains through testing the technology of quantum gravity. This means that consciousness is non-classical and must operate non-classically. If the results of this study are confirmed, it will be a significant step towards understanding how our brains and their consciousness work. This may deepen our understanding of the quantum mechanics of human consciousness and advance the fields of physics and biology. Scientists have discovered evidence that our brains may use quantum mechanisms to process information. Some isotope spin changes in the brain may also affect our body and brain reactions. For example, xenon with a nuclear spin of 1/2 can produce anesthesia, while xenon without spin cannot. In addition, differences in spin among various lithium isotopes can also affect the development and nurturing ability of rats. While these findings are significant, the brain is believed to be a classical system, making its workings difficult to explain. If quantum processes do exist in the brain, they would be challenging to observe and understand. Quantum processes are very difficult to detect, and we do not know what to look for. The lead author of the paper and Trinity College's neuroscientist, Christian Kerskens, said, "If the brain uses quantum computing, then these quantum operators may differ from those we already know. So how can we measure unknown quantum systems, especially when we have no equipment to measure these mysterious interactions?" Physics primarily comprises two fields, microphysics and gravity. The former studies the microdomain, such as atoms, photons, particles, and waves, whose interactions and behaviors are very different from those of the macroscopic world we know. The latter controls the motion of planets and stars and keeps humans on Earth. Unifying these fields under a single theory is what quantum gravity deals with, helping scientists understand the fundamental forces governing the universe. As both quantum gravity and quantum processes in the brain are complex, Trinity College Dublin scientists decided to use the same approach that other scientists are using to try to understand quantum gravity. The researchers stated in their paper, "Recent studies of quantum gravity suggest that an unknown system can act as a mediator between two known quantum systems if the medium itself is non-classical, and that there is interaction between the mediator and the unknown system. This approach can also be applied to quantum operations in the brain, which are believed to be related to consciousness and cognition. Using magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, technology, scientists observed whether proton rotations in the brain could become entangled through an unknown mediator to learn about the properties of the unknown system, similar to studying quantum gravity. The researchers found that if the unknown system could become entangled with a known system, such as proton rotation in the brain, then the unknown system must be quantum. They conducted an experiment with 40 participants using MRI scans and linked the data to the patient's heartbeats. A heartbeat is not just the movement of an organ inside the body, it also communicates with the brain in both directions and is associated with factors such as attention, pain, motivation, short-term memory, and aging. The researchers found that every time the heart beats, an electric signal called a heartbeat-induced potential is generated. This signal is related to the interaction between the proton rotation in the MRI signal and may be the result of entanglement, proving the existence of a non-classical mediator. This signal only appears when conscious, indicating that the brain is not classical as previously thought but a powerful quantum system. If these results can be confirmed, they may begin to reveal the secrets of how the brain performs powerful computations and generates consciousness.